Since you haven't really asked that is pertinent to the journal is how I understand the concept of youth at risk.
Yeah, go ahead and do that.
It's pertinent to the journal, but it's also really pertinent to the work that I do. When I think of the concept of children at risk or youth at risk, what I think about are the systems and practices that put people at risk. And for me, the onus is on figuring out what those systems are to change them. Because it's not that the kids have this at-risk characteristic that they bring with them. And I think a lot of times teachers do think of that. Oh, so-and-so is at risk because he or she is poor, because blah, blah, blah. And to me, it's a systemic issue. Just as a couple of examples, I used to be a learning disabilities teacher. And in developing an analysis of how learning disabilities got created, which I wrote about in Exceptional Children a while back, I started looking at the escalation of reading levels and what was normalized and considered normal reading over a period of years. And I got to thinking that, because as I was working with LD kids, to me they were perfectly normal kids who just didn't read very well. But they would be classified as at risk because they didn't read very well. And so I got to thinking about why is it that we pushed up expected reading levels, and instead of learning to teach kids who read at a wide variety of levels, and why is it that we, as you go through the grades, more and more knowledge is conveyed through reading and writing instead of through a more diversity of ways of teaching, because it's that narrowing down that ends up putting some kids at risk, because then they can't keep up. And that was the kids that I was teaching in learning disabilities. And so that got me to start looking at and wondering when playing with how can we open up what happens in the classroom so that more kids are successful. Or the work that I do in ethnic studies, you look at the curriculum and a predominantly white curriculum that turns off kids of color, especially the older they get and go through school and not only don't see themselves in there, but don't see a way of looking at the world that even makes sense. As kids become then disengaged from school, we'll look at the kids and you know, oh, they're at risk. Well, what are we doing in school that's putting them at risk? So for me, it's a systemic issue, not an onus on the kids issue, which I think is